Bonjour, mes amis. Welcome back, everyone, to my home in Paris. I'm going to cook with you today some focaccia bread. I've noticed online, especially in places like New Zealand, there seems to be a lot of people running out of bread in their supermarkets. So this is basic focaccia bread that's really easy to make at home. All you need is a warm room. You'll need 3/4 of a cup of lukewarm water, a 5-gram packet of dry yeast, 2 cups of flour, 1.5 teaspoons of salt, some coarse salt. I like to use Himalayan rock salt, not very much left there. Some olive oil, 12 to 20 olives, 1 to 2 teaspoons of rosemary. Right, using only lukewarm water. If you use hot water, you'll probably kill some of the yeast. Put the yeast in, the dry yeast, and give it a bit of a mix around. Now leave it to sit for about 5 minutes. While you're waiting for the yeast to do its thing, in a bowl, mix your flour and your salt. And make sure you're sifting your flour, get any of those nasty lumps out. Mix them all up a bit until they're well mixed. Make sure your hands are clean, your shirt is pulled up, and take out your whisk and pour in your yeast mixture. And then you're going to be mixing it all by hand. So get as much of that yeast mixture out as possible. And you keep mixing until it forms a dough. Okay, so I'm just gonna get this out of the bowl now, get rid of the bowl, and I'm gonna knead it by hand for about 4 to 5 minutes. Till it starts to become a bit smoother. Might check a wee bit of flour down as it seems to be sticking. And also, having the flour, if I can rub that on my fingers, helps get some of this dough off. See, all right, coming off my hands here. Just gonna put a little bit underneath here. Just prevent it sticking. Okay, might put a bit more. Alright, so you can see how it's kind of got all smooth, so we want to make it to a nice bowl shape for when we put it in the bowl. So what I've got here is a bowl that I've oiled, and I'm going to put this ball straight in it. And then I've got some cling film here, or glad wrap, or whatever you want to call it, that I'm just going to rub a tiny bit of oil on as well before I put it over top. Now, obviously, if you've got some sort of beeswax paper, that would do the same. It's just got to make a tight seal. So I'm just running some oil from my hands on the glad wrap before I chuck it over. Just get this. Hopefully this works. It's not as tight a seal as I'd want. But I'm just going to go put it in a warm place until it doubles in size. So I've just found a spot on my radiator. Almost doubled in size. So as you can see here, the dough has doubled in size. So I've prepared a little bit of a pan. What I've done to make sure that the paper sticks down is I've put a bit of vegetable oil underneath. While I'm preparing the pan even further, what I do is I get some olive oil, spread it around. Lots of olive oil needed here. Spread it around because it's going to sit on that base of olive oil. I'm going to salt the base of the pan. And I'm just going to spread out this so it covers the base of the pan. And then I'm going to just cover it and leave it again to rise till it doubles in size again. All right, now that it's doubled in size again, we're going to cover it with some olive oil. And we're gonna push in some dimples, just dimple it up a bit. Okay, we're just gonna push in some olives. Push them in. Sprinkle some rosemary. Try not to get it in a big dollop like I just did then. Okay, more olive oil, and it's ready to go in the oven, which has been preheated around 220 to 230, and we're going to put it in there for 30 to 40 minutes or until it's golden brown. Oh, sorry, forgot to add some more salt. My bad.
time at Overcooked. You can have a look. Oh, that looks absolutely gorgeous on the inside. So we'll enjoy that for dinner tonight.
Now, my focaccia bread, unfortunately, was a tiny bit overcooked, but still insanely delicious. I completely recommend doing it, even though you may overcook it slightly or even undercook it, it'll still be fabulous.